Matt here with Matt's Kayaking Adventure. Lately, with the warm weather coming around, there's been some talking about the Osage River and lock and dam. So we're going to talk about this danger area on the Osage River. Paddleboard buddy of mine a few weeks ago did a kayaking trip down this river. They got to this point and they portaged around river left, which is the side of the river that I am sitting on now. The landowners let them make their portage, but they were not happy about it. So I have before portaged around river right, the other side of the river, and it's doable, but it is pretty risky. So we're going to take a look at all these here in just a few minutes. Alright, coming up ahead right here is the lock portion of this dam. You can see right there, there's a lot of water coming off of that. That is a drop in the riverbed is what's causing that. You do not want to take a kayak over that. A few years ago, I don't know, 2-3 years, whatever, a pontoon boat thought, well, we can do that. And they went through there. And, they didn't make it. They had to be rescued by the fire department, water rescue, and I'm not even sure if the pontoon boat made it out safely. The people did, luckily. All this turbulent water right here? Yeah, not a good deal. To the other side, and I'll show you my portage. But yeah, you don't want to have a kayak come through there, because I guarantee it's not going to end well for you, and you will most definitely make the news. And it's not going to end well for you. Alright, so, let's go around this river bar. And check out the portage that I did a couple years ago. So I got over to river right. And this is where I made a portage in a 10-foot Pelican wreck kayak. Water level was so behind than what it is today, and I managed to portage around this dam. But you see all these rocks at this water level, I don't even want to try to attempt to get out of my boat with the water level the way it is today. When I did my portage, the river level was 14 feet. That drop you're looking at right there was just a little more than a bump in the river. But the hydraulics on this downriver side kept me from going over it, because I knew my abilities were not that good. So I chose to portage around. So this wall you see up there, I actually walked across the top of that wall with my kayak, came down, back in okay. But this is the kind of beach, riverbank you're looking at. And it's just not easy to get in or out right there. In here where I don't want to be. Camp. those are all river miles. 8 river miles downriver from Pike's Camp and Wardsville. 1.8 miles upriver from Mariosa Boat Ramp, Highway 5063 Bridge. So this is the location of it. Pretty to look at if you come upriver. Come downriver to it. Don't get too close because the current coming over, the dam will grab you quickly. And you do not want to take a kayak over this dam. Nobody's done it in recent years that I know of. I have heard of people going over it, and the outcome was not good. That's a lot of turbulent right there, no matter where you come over at. And unless you can almost make your kayak fly,